One of the questions we often get as master gardeners is, how do I test my soil? Well, in this video, we're going to do something on the ins and the outs of soil testing for the home gardener. So what kind of things will a soil test tell us? Well, it'll tell us something about the structure of our soil, the mineral structure of our soil. And it can also tell us something about the chemistry of our soil, which is things like the pH, which is the acidity or alkalinity of the soil, and possibly some of our nutrients. So one of the things we need to do is have a little bit of humility about our soil. We have to remember that soil is something that develops over thousands, if not tens of thousands of years. And your soil, for example, if you've been to Hawaii and seen the beautiful red dirt there, well, it's beautiful red dirt because it is tens, even hundreds or millions of years of weathering of this iron-rich, reddish volcanic rock that is the basis for that soil. Here in San Luis Obispo, particularly where I live, many of the soils come from tens of thousands of years of weathering of old sandstone. So again, one of the things we have to realize is that we're not going to probably make major changes to millions of years of evolution of that soil, but rather we're going to test, find out what's in our soil, and try to adapt to it with the right plants in the right place at the right time. Soil, as we utilize it, is actually a complex mixture. There's inorganic elements, which are classified by size, sand, silt, clay. Organic elements, both dead and alive, every little worm and insect and bacteria that's crawling through your soil will have an influence on how your plants grow. Okay, so basically there are three kind of tests that I'm going to tell you about. The first is the Google test, and we're going to show you a link to a site where you can actually hone down pretty much right to your property, you know, with your zip code and so forth, and you can see what the scientists, the geologists, the soil scientists have figured out about the general soil in your area and even the specific soil that you are living on. Now, a caveat here is that oftentimes if we live in a development, things have happened. There have been cuts and fills as foundations are laid. Sometimes soil is brought in, sometimes soil is removed. So the Google test, as I call it, will give you a general idea of what the soils are in your area, but not necessarily. You still have to figure out a little more about your own property. The next test after looking things up on Google is what we call the jar test. Now the jar test will give you an idea of the mineral structure of your soil. Sand, silt, clay. Sand, silt, and clay are classified basically by size. So clay is very fine. You've all seen clay. It's very, very dense sand at the opposite end of the extreme. And the ratios of sand, silt, and clay in your soil will influence a whole bunch of stuff, like how you water and how your soil will retain water, how your soil will retain and release nutrients for your plants. So the jar test, we're gonna show you a link. It's a fairly simple thing to do. There also is a table that comes with the jar test that will allow you to identify your pretty much your exact soil test. This is a finished jar. It actually takes about 48 hours to do a full jar test. But when it's done, you can see you come out with basically layers that are pretty easily discernible. There's a sand layer that settles out first, a silt layer that settles out next, and then a clay layer. Now, interestingly enough, the liquid that's left above looks pretty dark and dense, and that's because this particular soil, which comes out of my vegetable garden, has a huge amount of organic matter in it after being composted steadily for about 30 years. Okay, so the last of our three basic tests is a little bit of chemistry. It's our chemical test. You can get these online. There are different brands, different styles. They're all a little bit different. Your basic chemical test for a home gardener will probably give you four things. It'll give you the pH. pH is the acidity or alkalinity of your soil. And then it'll give you your three basic nutrients, which are nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. Beyond that, if you really need to start getting into the microelements, your boron, your molybdenum, your iron, and so forth, you probably, to get really accurate, you probably have to go to a professional lab. And we will give you some links to professional labs in this area where you can do so. But for a basic home gardener, and I get asked, how accurate are these? Some are probably fairly accurate. They're probably accurate enough that we can use them. Is the most important thing that we can talk about on the chemical test for the home gardener is pH. pH represents the acidity or the alkalinity of the soil. Acidity, think vinegar. Alkalinity, think baking soda. And this is something that you may be able to alter in your soil. Most plants like to be at least close to neutral, okay? Vegetables, most of the vegetables that we grow tend to want to be neutral to a little bit acidic. There are some plants that like to be very acidic. Some of the things that have grown traditionally in the peat bogs, like some of the berry plants, the blueberries, and so forth. But the reality is in our area, if you're a home gardener and you're going to grow something like that requires a ton of acidity, you may be better off growing in a container than trying to spend a lot of time and effort significantly lowering the pH of your soil. Okay, so here's an example of a typical home soil testing kit. As you can see, it's like a little miniature chemistry lab with test tubes and then different, what we call reagents or stuff, basically, solutions that help extract and demonstrate different aspects of your soil. So here's nitrogen extracting solution, potassium extracting solution, etc. And probably the most important thing, instructions. Soil test kit instructions, because everyone is going to be a little bit different. Everyone is going to have some different aspects to it. But using one of these kits, you can get an idea, at least, of the pH and some of the more basic nutrients. So in summary, we've given you three methods: the Google test, the jar test, and a home chemistry set that will allow you to get a better idea of the structure of your soil and the chemistry of your soil. But again, bottom line, you may be much better. Once you understand your soil, you may be better off adapting what you plant to your soil rather than spending huge amounts of energy trying to adapt your soil to what you want to plant. Again, Master Gardeners are available to answer questions, and in our next video, we will talk a little bit about amending your soil and what you can do to improve it.